Hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. Wow. Let's do that again then. Well, hello my lovely nestlings. If you are... Wow. Apparently I forgot how to do my own intro, so I'm just going to say welcome. Today I'm going to rank my last 12 eyeshadow palettes that came into my collection. But without kind of further ado, before my brain melts even more, let's just go into the ranking part here. Usually I say that I love all the palettes. This time though, there are palettes that are definitely more in the bottom for me. So what I kind of tried to do, I tried to rank them a little bit more by versatility maybe. Not specifically... Yeah, versatility. I think that's it. It's always kind of difficult to rank them. It's like choosing between your favorite children. Fortunately, I only have one. So there's that. But yeah, there are two palettes that are kind of meh quality-wise. And the rest are actually really good. So yeah, let's just get into it with number 12. Let's start with the lowest one that is... on my ranking list, and that's this one, the Revolution Forever Flawless We Are Love palette. This is their Pride palette of this year, and it's a rainbowy palette in a tin, and I don't know exactly why. I have played with it once, and it is just, there's a hair in here, a cat hair. I've played with it once and I don't know why, but I'm not really inspired by this palette, which is kind of weird because I usually love tones like this. It's just that, I don't know, maybe it's also because the shimmer formula is a bit weird in this one. I don't know if you can, maybe I can show you though. Where's the shimmer? I can push. Do you see my imprint, my fingerprint? And it's the same with the purple. And that kind of threw me off a little bit. They are also pretty difficult to pick up with a brush. So maybe that is it. It's just, I don't know, I loved the cause and I really wanted to try one in a tin. Now I don't know if this is the same quality as the other ones in a tin, but if it is, yeah, I'm not really that impressed. I think that the shimmers are pretty, so here's the pink one, which is a gorgeous color, are pretty, but I don't know, maybe a little bit thin, you know? So yeah, I don't really know what it is, but it is ranked lowest at number 12. And then let's go to number 11, and that is one of the quads from X Revolution. This is the Extortion quad. It looks like this. This is all green, but it is also no mattes. That is why it is lower. If it had a matte, I would have loved these two to be mattes. If these two had been mattes, it would have been ranked higher. The quality isn't bad, although the shimmer here has the same wonkiness that the shimmers in the other in the Pride palette has, but I do pick up more here. So yeah, the color story I really do love. I think it's really pretty. It's just that I can create a look on its own, so I can use the palette on its own, but because it is basically an all shimmer palette, it's, yeah, it's just, yeah, quality's nice. I don't think it warrants the higher price point though, but that is just me. Let's next go to something that I kind of need to, this is the reason why I say pre-made palettes, because I have here the Sassy Siennas from Dose of Color. The only reason that it is down here is color story, and it is an all matte palette. So I don't mind an all matte palette, but I don't use all matte palettes that often. The quality is great though. It's a really, really nice quality. The brush is not that good in my opinion, but the quality of the shades is really, really good. I do love the color story. This was a present by one of you. And in that same present, I received a bunch of singles from Divina. I will show them to you. So technically, I could kind of mention it because it's in a palette, but it's not in a pre-made palette. So I do want to show you the colors that I got as well. These are so, so pretty, guys. So pretty, but I thought, you know what, let's kind of keep it. I don't know where to rank this. So that is why I said, let's make it easy on myself and let's just go with pre-made palettes. So yeah, the Sassy Siennas is, I think, number 10 then, yeah? So again, it's not bad at all. I do like the color story. It's just not one that I grab for a lot, unless I do want to play with, for instance, the Divina shadows or another palette that I will touch in just a second. Let me get a little bit of water. Okay, let's go to Makeup Obsession, and this is the Sunshine Makes Me Happy palette. I have done a video with, I think, most of what I have here. I will link a bunch down in the description box. Here is the monochromatic mini palette, or at least I call the mini palette from Makeup Obsession, the yellow one. The reason that it is down here is because quality wise the mattes in this palette shine, at least in my opinion they do. The shimmers are very pretty, but there are only two shimmers that I want to use when I pull this palette, and that's these two yellow, real yellowy ones. The rest, yeah, the middle one is very, very pretty, but it is not something that I grabbed this palette for. So for me, the mattes shine. I said so in the video with this palette that I think it lacks depth. I would have loved this to be a matte because it then makes it a bit more versatile. So the reason that it is lower ranked is because of the versatility and the fact that the shimmers are, yeah, they're okay, but they are not as... Yeah, that's basically it. They're okay. If you have these, don't go swatching them because you get hard pan really, really quickly. Because you cannot really swatch these palettes nicely, at least in my opinion. Let's go then to number, what is it, 8 then, I think. Dit is 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, 8. Okay. And that is another quad from Makeup X Revolution. It's the one exclusive and it's a purple one. The reason that this is ranked a tiny bit higher is even though it is only 4 shades, I get 2 mattes here. And it makes it a lot more versatile because I can do a 1 matte crease basically with this one or with this one. And then pull in one of the shimmers. I can use this one and then deepen up this one. I can kind of create quite a few looks with this one. Now the mattes in here, this one is very, very nice. And this deep purple is okay. It's not a bad purple. It's not a terrific purple, but it's not a bad purple. You can work with it, or at least I can. I think it is... if you are having difficulty working with a shade like this, use it on a set base, you know, or just start off the look with this one. And then use that as your transition shade and then deepen it up with this. The shimmers are very nice. And here again, this formula is that wonky wetness again. I don't really know what to make of this formula. It's pretty, but it is a little bit difficult to pick up with the brush. It kind of reminds me a little bit of the Super Shock formula from Colourpop. But yeah, I think that the color story here is very, very interesting. And I can create quite a few looks with this one. You can use it on its own. You can use it as a companion palette. The quality is nice. Does this one warrant a higher price point? Yeah, you get a lot of shades. It's versatile. But yeah, not really. Just saying. Then the next one, it kind of hurts my heart a little bit to put this one here. This is the Nomad Studio 54 Quad. This is what she looks like. And what I actually did is I tapped this... Oh no, my battery is almost empty. I tapped this shade on my lid and it's so, so pretty. The reason that this one is lower is because it is not a standalone palette for me. I need to use it with something else. And that's not a problem. These are gorgeous, gorgeous shades. And let me just... This is a yellow with a pinky, but when I put it on top of here, it kind of, oh, it gives it a little bit more vibrancy. So I kind of need to put it where I can see it because I need to use this more. These are gorgeous as a topper. These are gorgeous to spruce up your look with a little bit. They are all duochrome goodness. And I love, love, love the brand so, so much. It's just that, yeah, I need to pull in more shades if I want to create a look with this. And that is why it is ranked number 7, I believe. I believe. So let's then next, yeah, let's go next to number 6. And this was also kind of like, where do I put this one? Because I kind of wanted to put this on the same spot as the next one I'm going to talk about. But I think that the next one is just a little bit, tiny bit higher. Before we go any further, let me change my battery. Otherwise, it will cut me off in just a, yeah, mid-sentence, mid-word. Yes? Okay, I'm back. Woohoo! I hope I'm still in the same spot. But yeah, let me just show you the palette that is ranked at number 6. And that's the Pretty in Pink from Makeup Obsession. When I did the video, I could not rank this one higher than the other one, the next one I'm going to talk about. But I think that just based on... I want to say based on versatility, but I'm kind of... Yeah, maybe... Yeah, I think the next one is just a hint more versatile... But yeah, they could have been on the same spot for all. Like, the quality on these is very, very nice. The mattes are great. The shimmers are very nice as well. I think that the quality on this one is better than the yellow one. I just love pink tones like this, guys. I just love these so much. So yeah, this is number, what did I say again? 6. I don't really know what to say about this anymore than I think the price is right. The quality is very nice. And I like the color story. That's it. I love those hot pink, pinky goodness stuff. So then let's go to my top 5. Let's start with number 5, which is then the sweet like candy from Makeup Obsession. Yeah, this one I can just create a tiny bit more looks with. I can go very, very light. I can go blue. I can go pink, purple, blue, purple, light. You know, I can just do so much more looks because I have a little bit more variety in the mattes, and I kind of hope that makes sense. The shimmers are very, very pretty as well. This is a very special, they swatch horribly, but this is a very special shade with a bluer base and then kind of a, I don't know, sparkly pink goodness in it. It's the same as this shade, but this shade is a topper. The nice thing about that is if you want to create a very blue purple look, you can use this one. If you want to create a more pink purple look but want to get the same effect as this one, use this one on top of this one or that one, you know, or on top of one of the shimmers, because that's new, because you can. But yeah, this is just a tiny bit more versatile. Let's go next to number 4, and this was actually every ranking. Usually I know kind of what I want to put on the bottom, but after the bottom 2, it's kind of difficult. Let's go to number 4 though, and number 4 is this one, the Lucky Bunny Envy palette. And yeah, I love the color story. I love the brand. I do have... Oh, I forgot to say, didn't I? I have a discount code with Nomad Cosmetics. It's linked down in the description box. It's... I think it's Nikki Raven 10. I think. I also have a code with Lucky Bunny Cosmetics. I think that is Nikki 10. But I'm actually not sure. They are listed down in the description box. But I do need to say that the Nomad palette I got in PR. That's the only thing that I got in PR, because the rest I paid for, just so you know. The color story is so, so interesting on this one. And the quality is very nice as well. However, there are a few shades that are maybe a little bit finicky to work with. Not specifically for me, but can be for a lot of other people. So yeah, it's just the fact that the color story as this one is at the moment, while I love it, not as appealing to me as the color stories I'm going to mention next. Does that make any sense? I hope so. I do need to swatch one shade though. I need to swatch the shade Chastity, because oh my lordy lordy. Ugh, gorgeous. Favorite shade in this palette. Did I say she's Australian based indie brand? I don't know. Let's go next then to my top 3. Number 3 is the LA Dreams palette from Makeup Obsession. The quality on this is very good. It's not a magnetic palette though, which their usual bigger size palettes are magnetic. This one is not. This color story I like so, so much. The quality is very good as well. There are some very interesting duochrome shades in here. Some are so, so pretty. This shade, oh, it's so pretty. It's just... Let me also kind of swatch it then on my skin. It's so unique. It's gorgeous. If you put it on top of a pink, it transforms the pink. You can put it on top of a green or combine it with a green. It's so pretty. And this one is also a duochrome. And this is basically the equivalent, but then in pink. It's just so, so... And I swatch horribly. The quality is really good. I love the color story. I can create so many different kinds of looks with this. I did... Did I do 5 looks or 6 looks? I don't remember, but I will link the video down below. I also did eye swatches with this. So yeah, it is my number 3. Because it's a color story that I gravitate towards a lot. And I think the quality is very, very nice. Let's then go to my number 2. And this is kind of... I'm still kind of thinking, did I rank them correctly? It's difficult. These last two are actually pretty difficult for me to rank. I kind of want to put them both on number 1. I can. It's my video. Yeah, I think I'm going to leave it as it is. Well, it is very, very difficult, and ask me in 5 minutes and it's probably going to be flipped. But yeah, my number two is the Lucky Bunny Greed palette. And I really love this palette though. There are this shade, this is my favorite shade in this palette. It's such a pretty palette. And this is her second palette. The formula in this is better than her first. It's one of the reasons it's ranked higher, but also the color story. I love these colors so much. I can create a bunch of different looks with this. Maybe it's just the fact that I kind of needed to nitpick why I put this on the number two spot. And I think it's just because of the fact that if I were to have a gray in here, a gray matte, it would make it even better for me. So one of these I could have kind of done without, and then a gray matte. I think that then it would have been my perfect. I'm nitpicking, people. I'm really nitpicking. The formula is great. The looks that I created with this one are amazing, and I'm very happy with the looks that I created. It is, though, basically a pink or a purple look. You know, that is also the nitpicky part. I can use this palette for a whole month and be happy with it, and just use this shade for a week on the lid and I will be happy. But yeah, I kind of needed to nitpick to put this on the second place, and I kind of hope that makes sense. I do love the palette though. Then my number one, you may have guessed it if you have been following me, is the Lethal Cosmetics After Dark palette. Now I know that this is my first Lethal Cosmetics time. Yes, it's the first time that I'm using Lethal Cosmetics that I have tried them. I understood that this is not their normal formula. I have no idea, guys. I love this palette. And the reason that this is number one, first off, I really, really like how the shadows performed. But it's also more versatile. This is, I think, from everything that I have here, the most versatile and also the one that I want to use. I can create so many different looks with this. It's just, yeah, I really, really like this palette, guys. So yeah, the mattes worked beautifully, the shimmers worked beautifully. I have done a bunch of looks with this. I love this palette a lot. So yeah, and that is going to be it. I tried to keep it short and sweet, but yeah, who am I kidding? It's never short and sweet with me. Well, maybe sweet, and I am short. But my videos tend to be on the longer side. That was it, guys. That was my ranking, my last 10 palettes that came into my collection, and yeah, I think that is it. I have gotten since some new palettes, but they don't fit in this video, so I will save those for the next one. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. Didn't I just say that? I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I'm going to see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.